station on Space to Ground.
Welcome to Space to Ground. I'm Gary Jordan. Right now, we have a few more crew members on their way to the International Space Station. Drew Feustel and Ricky Arnold of NASA, as well as Oleg Artemyev of Roscosmos, lifted off from the Baikonur Cosmodrome on March 21st. They're now on a two-day journey to the space station to join their fellow crew members, Scott Tingle of NASA, Anton Shkaplerov of Roscosmos, and Norishige Kanai of the Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency, JAXA. They're set to dock Friday, March 23rd, so tune into NASA TV or our website to see the schedule and watch their arrival live. The two NASA residents will have to get used to their space legs pretty quickly, because next week they're heading right back out the door to go for a spacewalk. After less than a week on board the station, veteran astronauts Drew Feustel and Ricky Arnold are set to don their spacesuits for 6.5 hours of installing new equipment and cameras outside on Thursday, March 29th. One of the primary tasks is installing additional wireless communications equipment for an experiment called EcoStress that will measure the temperature of plants on Earth to better understand how much water they need and how they respond to stress. We'll cover the whole excursion live, so once again head to nasa.gov/NTV for the latest on how you can watch the spacewalk while it's happening. Suda on Twitter wants to know if astronauts' movement on the space station affects the station's orbit. Well, not the orbit per se, it's pretty stable at 250 miles above the Earth. But think of Newton's third law. Every action has an equal and opposite reaction. Every time an astronaut pushes off a handrail or wall of a module, that astronaut is applying a force to the station. The station is huge, so the force does very little to the whole structure. What little effect it does have is automatically corrected for by the attitude control system on the International Space Station. Mark Vandehyde did a demonstration while he was on board the station recently to demonstrate Newton's third law, using a basketball and his fellow crewmate Joe Acaba to show the difference between applying force to an object of much smaller mass and an object of equal mass, respectively. Keep sending in questions using the hashtag #SpaceToGround. We'll see you next week.
Subscribe for more space.